Millions of BADR, 313. Inshallah, so our munshid is going to now begin, inshallah, with a few qasidas and then continue with the names of the people of BADR, inshallah.
صلاة الله سلام الله على طه رسول الله صلاة الله سلام الله على ياسين حبيب الله على ياسين حبيب الله توسلنا ببسم الله وبالهادي رسول الله وكل مجاهد لله بيا للبدر يا الله إلهي سلم الأمة من الآفات والنقمة ومن هم ومن غمة بأهل البدر يا الله بأهل البدر يا الله صلاة الله سلام الله على طه رسول الله صلاة الله سلام الله على ياسين حبيب الله على ياسين حبيب الله إلهي نجنا واكشف جميع أذية واصرف مكائد العدا والطوف بأهل البدر يا الله إلهي نافس الكربة من العاصين والعطبة وكل بلية ووبا بأهل البدر يا الله بأهل البدر يا الله صلاة الله سلام الله على طه رسول الله صلاة الله سلام الله على ياسين حبيب الله على ياسين حبيب الله فكم من رحمة حصلت وكم من ذلة فصلت وكم من نعمة وصلت بأهل البدر يا الله وكم أغنيت ذا العمر وكم أوليت ذا الفقر وكم عافيت ذا الوزر بأهل البدر يا الله بأهل البدر يا الله صلاة الله سلام الله على طه رسول الله صلاة الله سلام الله على ياسين حبيب الله على ياسين حبيب الله إلهي اكفر وأكرمنا بنيل مطالب منا ودفع مساءة عنا بأهل البدر يا الله إلهي أنت ذو لطف وذو فضل وذو عطف وكم من كربة تنفي بأهل البدر يا الله بأهل البدر يا الله صلاة الله سلام الله على طه رسول الله صلاة الله سلام الله على ياسين حبيب الله على ياسين حبيب الله وصل على النبي البر بلا عد ولا حصر وآل سادة غري بأهل البدر يا الله بأهل البدر يا الله صلاة الله سلام الله على طه رسول الله صلاة الله سلام الله على ياسين حبيب الله صلاة الله سلام الله على ياسين حبيب الله على ياسين حبيب الله
بدرية وافت ببرهان باهر أحدية في سردها سر ظهر جمعت لأسماء الذين سموا ذو رامت للعلا في المجد من صحب غرر جنيت فواكه الجانية من جانا بدرية أحدية طاب الثمر ساقي بواسكها الناظرة جعفر والذي أدنى جناها واختبر لكن من النسب الشهيرة جردت في جلها لتكون أوجز مختصر فنذرت كل اسم بها بعلامات قرنت بذكر أبيه تغنيم النظر فمهاجيه يوعلي منه بميمه وكذا بأو أوسيهم في المنتظر والخزراجي بخائه وكذا الشاهد بشينه من فوق نظم مبتكر لله قوم قد حبوا بفضيلة قطعوا بها أطماع أقوى من أخر فبخلهم فالله قد قال اعملوا ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر شرف سامت بنظامهم وسنا وقد سميت بجالية الكدر حسن حصين من خطوب أو حالت من يستجر بها في المعضلات يجر فبخلهم فالله قد قال اعملوا ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر قد جربت بين الآنام تلاوة أيضا وعلا في الإقامات والسفر فلكم أغنى فقيرا ذو النادى ولكم بها عبدا كسيرا قد جبر وختمتها متوسلا ببقية أصحابي إجمالا وسادات خخر والتابعين لهم كذاك أئمة بشريعة الهادي الممجد هم وزر إليها إن كربت ببرمة يوما ولازمها العشايا والبكر وبدأ بأول شافع ومشفع طه المرجى المصطفى خير البشر عبا الهناء على المهيمن والصلاة على الرسول وقل بنظم كالدرر عال وغال ذي قواف جمة رائية من كامل عذب فخر ربي بسيدنا محمد الأب الخير الأرية من به شرفت مضر سلم عليه وصلي ما هب الصبا أزكى صلاة دائما لا تنحصر فبجائه وهو المشفع في الورى يوم المعاد إذا أنهى خطب العمر إني سألتك وهو أفضل من سئلت به ومن أثنى عليك ومن شكر فبخل لهم فالله قد قال اعملوا ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر وبأفضل الأملاك سيدنا الذي بالوحي قد وفى إلى خير البشر وكذا بميكائيل سيدنا الراضي من فضله بين الملائك معتبر وكذا بإسرافيل سيدنا الذي بالنفخ يوم العرض في صور اشتهر وكذا بسيدنا الذي حاز العلا وبقبض أرواح الخلائق قد أمر فهم الذين مع الرسول محمد في يوم بدر جاهدوا من قد كفر وصديقه
الصديق سيدنا أبي بكر خليفته
المقدم في الخبر وفي فاتح الأمصار في غزواته مصباح أهل الخلد سيدنا عمر وكذا بذي النورين سيدنا الفتى عثمان وردت بمدحته الزمر وكذا بباب مدينة العلم الفتى الكرار سيدنا علي ذي الفخر وكذا بطلحة والزبير رحى الوغى وكذا ابن عوف عبد الرحمن وبر وكذا بسعد مع سعيد والأمين أبي عبيدة من بمعروف أمر وكذا بعم رسولك المختار ليث الله حمزة من سما وسطى وكر
فبخل لهم فالله قد قال اعملوا ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر
والحارث الأوسي ثم بمالك وسليمهم وبسالم مقري الصور وبثقفهم وبجابر وجبيرهم
وبجابر وأنيسهم
أسدي الظفر وبعامل وبعائد وبعامل من جرعوا الأعداء كأسا ما أمر والحارث الأوسي ثم حريثهم والحارث المولى وعتبى من بتر وبكعبهم وبعاصم
وصهيبهم وبلالهم
ذاك المؤذن في السحر وبجيرهم وبعاصم وخبيبهم وبشيرهم وبسعدهم ذاك الأبر وتميمهم وسليمهم وتميمهم أيضا وربعاش
وسعد
من ظفر وإياسهم وبأوسهم والأرقم البدري مع آسام بدا من دقر أيضا وبالعجلان ثم عديهم وسراقة السام
الذي
ثم انتبر وسنانهم وبسهلهم وبسغرة الإبطال أرباب الأعنة والوتر والنضر والنعمان
والنعمان من شهدت لهم
ثم المشاهد والأثر وبزيدهم وزيادهم وبمعبد وأبي خزيمة من لهندي شهر فبخل لهم
فالله قد قال اعملوا ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر
وزيادهم وبسهلهم وشهدهم وصفان من بالخلد قد أضحى وقر وقتادة الأوسي مع سلمان كذا سن وعقبة ثم عتبة ذو الكف
وبسالهم وخداشهم وخراشهم
من أثخنوا بالسمر وخزا من دبر وبعامل وبمالك وبمرثل وبمالك وبمهجع مولى عمر ومعتب وبمعبد وبمعقل ومعتب ومعادهم أهل الصدر وكذا قدامة مع رفاعة
من سما
وبخالد وبثابت يوم الوغر وبمالك ومعاذهم ومحرز وكذا رفاعة ذو النظر وكذا بعبد الله مع خلادهم
وكذا بعبد
الله ذاك المختبر وكذا بعبد الله ثم سليمهم وملينهم وبمصرح
من قد حضر
والمنذر الأوسي ثم يزيدهم وبرافع مع رافع العرب الذكر وأبي عقيل مع أبي حسن وعبد الله ثم أبي
سليط
من قهر والحارث الأوسي ثم اليمنى برافع وبذي الشمالين الشهيد من اشتهر فبخل لهم
فالله قد قال اعملوا
ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر وكذا بحادثة الهزب مع أبرى وكذا ببسبة المجيد المعتبر والأخنس المولى وعظمة مع تميمهم وأسعد مع أبي من بتر ومحمد وبمحرز وبثابت
ورخيلة الصيد الجحاجيح الغرر
وبزيدهم وبوهبهم ويزيد من كسب الشهادة وهي أربح ما تجر وكذا بمسعود وعتبة مع عبادهم وخارجة الذي بن من نثر وكذا بثعلبة الغزنفر من كما أيضا وبالمغدار مع زيد الوطر وكذا عمارة والحسين وأوسهم وأبو حذيفة مع عمارة من فخر أيضا بخلاد ومسعود كذا عكاشة السامي ببشرى كالقمر
وبحاطب ثم الحباب وحاطب من ثم صدقه النبي بما اعتذر
وكذا بفروة مع يزيد وثابت يوم التقى الجمعان والكفر انزجر فسنانهم والحارث البدري ثم مسوادهم وصبيحهم صيد الظفر وكذا عبادة مع خليفة منهم وأبو لبابة قاسم أهل الدعر فبخل لهم
فالله قد قال اعملوا ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر
وعميرهم
ومعوذ وسليطهم ومعاذهم تالي الكتاب المستقر
وبسعدهم ويزيدهم وبثابت من قد سموا بدو البرية والحضر
وعويلهم وعياضهم
وبجيرهم
وكذا بعبدة ثم
عمار الجبر وكذا بشماس
وجبار الوغى
وأبي الحنة ثم عمره الأغر وبعمرهم
والخنيسهم
وإياسهم
صحب الذي سبعين كالقتلى أسر
وبزيدهم وبسعدهم وزيادهم من صيب الباغي أذل من اليعر وكذا المجدر ثم غنى من معا
وكذا نعيمان الفتى
حسن السير والحارس الأوسي ثم بعاقل من بشهادة
حل أحسن مستقر وكذا ببحاث ولبدة
مع أبي أيوب ثم معاتب صحب المبر
وعطية البدري مع صيفيهم
وكذا أبو داود من ثم انتصر وكذا أبو مخشير وعبد الله ثم سواد البدري إنسان البصر أيضا أبو شيخان كذا بخزيمهم وكذا بخباب وذخوان الأبر فبخل لهم فالله قد قال اعملوا ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر وكذا أبو قيس وعبد الله ثم الحارث الزحاف المفر وكذا بعبد الله ثم برافع وكذا بعبد الله ذي البأس الأبر
وأبي لسبرة
ثم عبد الله ثم
بحمزة المرديد
وكذا بمسعود وعبد الله مع عبادك الشهم الذي ليلا جار وأبي قتادة ثم عبد الله ثم الحارث المولى وعباد اللبى
أيضا أبو سلمى كذا ومعاذهم
وكذا وديعة من الذي للمجد جار ويزيد والنعمان ثم عميرهم
وكذا عبد الله من منحى النظر
وأبي الكبشة ثم عبد الله ذاك الليث دمر للصفوف
إذا قطر وكذا
بعبد الله ثم بوابهم
والفاكه البدري
أرباب يسر وبعامر ثم طفيل وعامر من أثخل الأعداء وخزا ما أمر وعضيمة البدري مع خلادهم وهلالهم وكذا بعبس من قهر وبواقد
وبهانئ
والحارث الأوسي ثم يزيد من جلى وسر فبخيل لهم فالله قد قال اعملوا ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر ويزيد مع ودقى وعبد الله
ثم السائب المولى فتى فتكين
وبقيسهم
وعميلهم وبكعبهم وأبي سهام من لغى الهيجا سجر والحارث المولى وعبد الله ثم
عبيدهم وعميرهم
من قال شتر وكذا أبو الهيثام
خبع ثنا شرى
وكذا بعبد الله منهم من بسر ويزيد مع عمر وعبد الله ثم الحارث الأوسي
مردي ما دحر
وعميرهم وعبيدهم وكذا بعبد الله مع سلمى
نصيدهم عبر وكذا بعبد الله ثم عبيدهم خنوا الشهادة وهي أفضل ما ادخر
وأبي اللي خارجت
الذي دانت له قنن المفاخر فامتطاها وانتبر
وبعبد ربه والطفيل وقيسهم وكذا بعقبة للعيدى من قد ناحر
وكذا أبو الأعور وقيس منهم وكذا أبو مرثد وعمر من داحر وكذا بطمرة
مع أبي خلاد
المطعن قرم هزبي رضا من سافر وبسهلهم وبعامر ثم الطفيل المنتصر فبخل لهم فالله قد قال اعملوا ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر أيضا وبالنعمان والنعمان مع سلمى ببدر من ظفر وأبي اللحنة ثم عبد الله ثم
بقطبات السامي
لديك من استقر وكذا بعبد الله ثم بعمرهم وأبي لطلحة من هنالك قد عاكر
وكذا بعبد الله ثم معاذهم
وبعمرهم من كر يوم الكفر فر والمنذر البدري ثم المنذر بمحمد وبسعدهم من قد أطر
وبعمرهم وكذا بعبد الله
من أردى أبا جهل فصار إلى سقر
أيضا وبالبدري منه مصعب
وبسعدهم
وكذا رفاعة من نظر وكذا عبيدة ثم ثعلبة الذي بالعضب بدد هم فغدا شذا وبمالك ثم الربيع ومالك وخليل وبرافع من قد بادر وكذا بمسعود
وخول وخوات
ومسعود وخباب الواعر وبثابت وبخالد وبمالك وسماكهم وكذا بخلاد الزمر
ومعود وشريكهم
وشجاعهم أيضا وبالضحاك أقمار الصور فبخل لهم فالله قد قال اعملوا
ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر وكذا بعبد الله ثم بعوفهم وبماليل مع طالب
من كسر
وسهيلهم وحرامهم وبسعدهم وكذا بثعلبة الأجبر من اشتهر
وبعبد الرحمن كذا وبعامر وسراقة البدري قاسم من فجر
والحارث البدري مع
مدلاجهم وسهيلهم وسليمهم خدن الوزر وبعمرهم وسويبيط وبسعدهم وكذا
أبو مسعود الصيد العزر وأبو حبيب ثم عقبة
والفتى
عتبان من صرع الأعادي في الحفر وبنوفل وبراشد وكذا أبو طياح الفتاك
فيهم من أصر
بصر وأب لي صرمة ثم عبد الله مع سفيان مع عمرو ببدر من ثار فبخلاهم فالله قد قال اعملوا ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر وبمعنهم وبسالم وبمالك وبمعنهم وحبيبهم ذاك الآغر وبعاصم وبعامل وبعاصم من قد حابوا فضلا واجرا قد وافر وكذا رفاعة مع ربيعة من سامى وعميرهم وكذا بعمرو من فاخر وأبي دجانة
ثم حارثة الفتى
وكذا بعقبة من حابوا حور الحور وكذا بمسعود مع النعمان ثم هبيلهم وكذا بعثمان الآبر ومبشر وبسعدهم وببشرهم أيضا وبالضحاك ثم أبي الياسر وبفروة مع ودق القيس من إذا لاقوا العدا بكريهات هزموا الزمر وكذا بالأملاك من قد أحضروا بدرا لنصر المصطفى هذه البشر
فبخلاهم فالله قد قال اعملوا ما شئتم فالذنب منكم مغتفر. وكذا بفاطمة التي فضلت على
كل النساء وقلدت عقد الفاخر أيضا وبالحسنين سبطا سيد الكونين من بكسائه لهما ستر وبعمه
العباس
ثم بنجله الحبري عبد الله نبراس الفاكر وكذا بكل الآل والأصحاب والأزواج
والعمات
ربات الخافر وعلي سجاد مصباح الدجا
وبباقر من للعم عالم قد باقر
وبصادق وبكاظم ثم الرضا من للمساجد والمدارس قد عامر
والأمجادين نقيهم
وتقيهم والعسكري أئمة أثنى عشر وبختمهم نحل الرسول محمد المهدي الآتي الإمام المنتظر وكذا بباقي التابعين أولي التقى والعادل الأموي سيدنا عمر وأبي حنيفة وابن إدريس الفتى وبمالك وبأحمد الأسد الغرر وبمن لديك له مقام قد سامى قطب الزمان وكل قطب فيه مر وبمن سوقوا صهباء حبك من هم أهل الهيام والأخطاء من سكر وكذا بمن شهدوا والجمال
من جافت
ليلا جنوبهم بالسهر أيضا وكيلانيهم غوث والورى وكذا طيب المشتهر
وبسيد البدوي قل ستره
وبقطبهم ذاك الرفاعي الآغر أن تحسن العقبية وتمنح الرضا وتمنى بالحسنى وتقضي لي والأطر وكذا تحقق لي ظنوني فيك يا من لا يخيب من إليه قريب وتقيلني والعثرات يا ربي ولا سواك يقيل عثرت
من عثر وتعيذني من كل خطب فحيح
ومن العدا من رماني منهم بضل ومن الحسود وكل شيطان ومن ومن على كيدي أصر وتحفني
بخفي لطفك
في القضايا من بنا ما زال يا لطف في القدر وتجيرني من فتنة ما حيا مات وكل ما بق وإذا دانا مني الحمام تميتني ربي على حسن الختام بلا ذعر وتجيرني منا من النيران في اليوم
يهول الخلق من هول راحر
وبجنات الفردوس تسكنني مع المختار
ثم إليك تمنح النظر ثم الصلاة مع السلام على الذي
أيده برب الملائك والملائك والبشر والآل والصحب الضراغم في الوغى صيد المآثل والمشاهد والظفر.
Inshallah, we're going to move, inshallah, from hearing from the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to praise of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the people of Badr. We're going to move, inshallah, to hearing speeches from our resident teachers here in Liverpool, inshallah. We're going to be with Sheikh Haroon and then followed by Sheikh Ibrahim, inshallah, from some of the lessons taken from the Battle of Badr.
الحمد لله رب العالمين وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على حبيبنا محمد الصادق الوعد الأمين المبعوث رحمة للعالمين وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين وعلى أصحابه الغر المحجلين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. Amma ba'd. The first thing to mention, as some of the salihin, as some of the righteous, they mentioned, عند ذكر الصالحين تنزل الرحمة, that when the righteous are mentioned and spoken of, a mercy descends. We're in the month of mercy, we're in times of mercy, yet there's no one that we consider to be amongst the righteous greater than Ahl al-Badr, than the people of Badr. After the prophets, they are the greatest of the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so when we recite Al-Badriya, the names of the 313 blessed souls that stood on the fields of Badr, at the head of them, our Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, supported by 5,000 angels, there's no greater descent of mercy that will come down. Reading 313 names of those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them, اعملوا ما شئتم فإني قد غفرت لكم. Of those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to them, directly addressing them through the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, do whatever you want because I've forgiven you. After they stood at the plains of Badr, giving their lives for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, any act that they had done had already been forgiven. And the greatest example of that, Sayyidina Hatib ibn Abi Balta'ah, Sayyidina Hatib ibn Abi Balta'ah, who did ultimately what was an act of treachery. Whatever his motives were, he did ultimately an act of treachery, where he sent an advance warning to the people of Mecca of the approach of the armies of the Prophet that conquers the Fatih. And when eventually it comes out, and Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu wants him to be killed, which any traitor would be deserving of, the ultimate act, al-khiyanat al-uzma, treachery. Yet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says to Sayyidina Umar, what will make you understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven him? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, اعملوا ما شئتم فإني قد غفرت لكم. Do whatever you want because I've forgiven you. This is treachery from a companion. But he's already been forgiven. He's already been forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So when we mention the names of these blessed souls, then we are receiving, or even for those who didn't read along with those 313 names, we're in the presence of divine mercy descending because of those souls that were selected by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that great moment of Badr. And as we sit here and we come together to celebrate that great moment. And moments are only great because of people. Moments are only great because of people. Badr is nothing. The plains of Badr is nothing. The day of 17th of Ramadan is nothing. Times and places only become special because of the people. of the people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are there. It's the great sacrifices of Ahl Badr that makes the moment of the place of Badr worth going to travel to and taking the blessing from. And the day of Badr worth speaking about. It's because of those souls that Badr is special. It's because of those 313 supported by 5,000 angels that Badr is special. So we gather because of them. It's not even the 17th of Ramadan. It's because the people who stood on the 17th of Ramadan giving everything for Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we gather because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed them. He instructed us. وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed us, remind them of the name of the days of the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ayyamillah. Dhakkirhum bi ayyamillah. So as we gather on the day of Badr in commemoration of Ahl Badr, of the people of Badr, of the people of Badr, we are fulfilling an obligation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dhakkirhum bi ayyamillah. That we remind each other about these great days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Badr is one of the greatest days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If Badr is not considered one of the greatest days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what meaning is there to the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Intahlik hadhi al-isaba. Intahlik hadhi al-isaba. If this band of people, 313 souls, if they're destroyed, if they're defeated, then there'll be nobody left on the face of the earth to worship you. Such a significant day in the history of humanity. That's ayyamillah. These are the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We could not come here and pray and read Quran and do all of these blessed great acts and experience these great moments with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had it not been for Ahl al-Badr. Had it not been for Ahl al-Badr. All of those souls, if they'd not been there, if they'd not stood against the armies of kufr, the armies of disbelief, we could not say La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. We could never stand and say Allahu Akbar. We could never read Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. It's because of Ahl Badr. It's because the great victory that came through the people of Badr that we're able to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All those thousands, all those hundreds of years later, and all of those distant miles away from Badr, we're still able to speak about them because those great people of Badr. وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. So we remind ourselves as time continues to move on, and as the day of Badr will finish and then Ramadan will finish, then we celebrate and we go back to our normal behavior. We just need to come back every so often, every year, and just remind ourselves of the sacrifice of the people of Badr. We would be nothing. We'd be baha'im. We'd be animals in a complete state of misguidance had it not been for the great victory of Badr through the people of Badr. So dhakkirhum bi ayyamillah. Just keep on reminding ourselves of these times of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that have been made holy and special and sacred because of those people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But ultimately, as we heard at the beginning, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He speaks about Badr, and when we come to think about these great moments in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and these great moments around these great people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all of the lessons that we want to understand, we'll find them in the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll find them in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you want to understand Badr, then go and read Surah Al-Anfal. Go and read Surah Al-Anfal. Go and read Surah Al-Anfal, because Surah Al-Anfal is Surah Al-Badr. From the beginning to end, all of Surah Al-Anfal is a lesson about Badr. And however much seerah that you study, you will not get a true insight into what actually happened and took place at Badr unless you read what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. Our commentary is worthless. It's the commentary of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that matters. And in Surah Ali Imran, in Surah Al-Anfal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us twice, وَمَنْ نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَكِيمِ وَمَنْ نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. The victory of Badr only came because the Nasr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells him in Surah Al-Anfal, He tells him in Surah Al-Anfal that some of you actually went out to fight against the caravan of Abu Sufyan that was coming from Sham, from Syria. They went to intercept the caravan that came out of Sham. And some of you, that was their motive. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted something higher than that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted something higher than that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted the truth to be manifest. لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّ. That the truth of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dominates over every other way. The Nasr only comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَنْ نَصْرُ إلا من عند الله. Victory only comes because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the condition to receive His Nasr. Badr was about the Nasr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The only battle in which angels directly participated. The only battle in which angels actually fought. In which unbelievers were getting killed by. Were getting killed by the angels. Sahaba, they're telling us that in front of them, the kuffar are dropping in front of them. They've not touched them, but bodies are falling in front of them because they're getting killed by the angels. وَمَن نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. Victory is only coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It wasn't even about those 313. Miracles were taking place at that moment because the Nasr was coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because the victory was coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, how do we take our nasib from the great Nasr that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Ahlul Nasr, Al-Mansurun fi Badr? How can we take our portion of the great victory that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to those victorious souls, the people of Badr? Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, in tansurullaha yansurkum. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, in tansurullaha yansurkum. Badr is about the Nasr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing happened there. وَمَن نَصْرُ إِلَّا مِنْ عِنْدِ اللَّهِ. It was only because the Nasr came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The victory came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But how are we going to taste some of what they earned? And the Nasr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was such that whatever they did after, they were forgiven. The ultimate Nasr. That's قَوْمٌ مَنْصُورُونَ. The ultimate victory is that anything you do after that, it's... you've already been forgiven just because of those moments that they stood at Badr. In tansurullaha yansurkum. If you give victory to Allah, Allah will give you nasr. You give nasr to Allah, Allah will give you nasr. A few days ago, somebody actually, as we were coming into Felicity House, somebody actually asked, how can we actually give nasr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How do we give victory to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Unsuru deen Allah. Unsuru shari'at Allah. Unsuru deen Allah. Unsuru shari'at Allah. Give victory to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give victory to the shari'ah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Live. Give victory to the religion of Allah by living the religion of Allah. Give victory to the shari'ah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by living the shari'ah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By living the Lord of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yansurkum. Then the Nasr, that Ahl Badr, they taste some of that will come to you. وَيُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ. And He will make your feet firm. And in these times where we're coming almost to the point that the Prophet ﷺ is speaking about, if this band of people are defeated, who will worship you on the face of the earth? We're not too far away from a point where there'll be nobody left on the face of the earth worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We're not too far away from that. But if you give Nasr to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ. As people are going to turn their backs on the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's going to make your feet firm. And He's not going to let you shake. Just give nasr to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Give nasr to the sharia of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the last thing to mention, as the Prophet is making that statement, the night before Badr, the actual war, as the Prophet and he's shedding tears and beseeching Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he makes a statement that, if you think about it, it's actually mind-blowing, about the du'as of the Prophet ﷺ. The Prophet ﷺ, part of the du'a he makes, Allahumma anjiz ma wa'adtani. Allahumma anjiz ma wa'adtani. Allahumma atini ma wa'adtani. Oh Allah, fulfill what you've promised me. Oh Allah, give me what you've promised me. If this band of people are defeated, there'll be nobody left on the face of this earth to worship. The Prophet ﷺ, last night, the night of Badr, he's in tears crying in front of Allah, he's in sujood in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what's he asking? He's asking Allah, give me what you've already promised me. Give me what you've already promised me. You promised me that this deen will be victorious. Give me what you've already promised me. If you're told that you're getting this, Our natures, we're not even going to ask for it because we've got it. If somebody tells you, I promise you I'll give you that, we're not even going to ask for it because it's already been given. But the rububiyyah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dictates that even if He's already promised that He's given you, you still ask Him. and the ubudiyya of the Prophet dictates, even though you've already been told you're getting, you still ask him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The fact that he's the Lord dictates that even though he's already given you his promise, you're still going to ask him. And the nature of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, being Abdullah, the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is that even though you've already been promised, you're still a slave and you keep on asking. You keep on asking. One of the great lessons of Badr, on the night before the victory that he was already promised and he was told about. He's promised and he's told about. He's still in sujood worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's still asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He still never loses sight of the fact that he's the Lord and I'm the slave. That he's the Lord and I'm the slave. Walhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen wa la'afmin.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Hamdan yuafi ni'mahu yukafi wa mazidah. Ya Rabbana laka alhamdu kama yanbaghi li jalali wajhik wa li azim sultanik. Subhanaka la nuhsi thana'an alayka anta kama athnayta ala nafsik. Falaka alhamdu hatta tarda wa laka alhamdu idha radita wa laka alhamdu ba'da rida. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala Sayyidina Muhammad fil awwalin. Wa salli wa sallim ala Sayyidina Muhammad fil akhirin. Wa salli wa sallim ala Sayyidina Muhammad fi kulli waqtin wa heen. Wa salli wa sallim ala Sayyidina Muhammad fil mal al-ala la yawmiddin. Wa salli wa sallim ala Sayyidina Muhammad hatta tarith al-arda wa man alayha anta khayru warithin. Alhamdulillah, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has gathered us subhanahu wa ta'ala upon one of those great days that we have heard that we should be reminded of. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dhakirhum bi ayyamillah, remind them of the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are the days in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala discloses himself and discloses his favor to his slaves, Jalla Jalala wa Ta'ata Adamato. You know, the great day of Jum'ah, it's a day of disclosure. And the great month of Ramadan, it's a day of disclosure. You know, the year in which the Prophet ﷺ was born on the day, the year in which the Prophet ﷺ was revealed unto on the day in which the Rasul ﷺ migrated in the year. All of these are days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, time extended by him Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala to either matter to his slaves as a means of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disclosing himself and disclosing his favor upon his slaves Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala to either matter. And that is why the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam may remind us, and we're often reminded of the tradition of Sayyidina Muhammad ibn Maslama rahimahullah ta'ala inside of al-Tabarani with the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, inna li ayyami dahrikum hadha la nafahatun ala fata'arradu laha. That verily in this time extended unto you, they are nafahat, disclosures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether it brings mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whether it brings grace from him subhanahu wa ta'ala, or whether it brings favors from the Lord Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'azamatu. Ala fata'arradu laha. Will you not expose yourself to these favors dispersed and this divine nature disclosed Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'azamatu. Hakadha the words of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. From his favor is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows us to expose ourselves to him subhanahu wa ta'ala and to the favors that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has bestowed upon those who went before us and will bestow upon those who come after us, who expose us to the blessed nature of this day. And it's not just that mashallah tabarakah is the blessed month of Ramadan and that the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was disclosed inside of the blessed month of Ramadan. It's not just likewise that it was upon the 17th of Ramadan. The 17th of Ramadan, that is inna anzalnahu fi laylatul qadr. That was the beginning of this religion, was the 17th of Ramadan, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the Quran, whether inside of the unseen realm, unto the great Baytul Izzar inside of the fair sky, or likewise ila qalbin nabi, otherwise to the heart of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, in the physical sense inside of this realm. It was the 17th of Ramadan. Likewise also it was the blessed day of Jum'ah, the Jum'ah khairul yawm tala'at alayhi shams, the best day that the actual sun has ever risen upon. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all of these conspired in order to manifest the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the ultimate favor of the Lord Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'adhamato to us, whether we are believers or whether we are non-believers, the ultimate favor is His beloved sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam wa kalamu. And that is the word of the Lord Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'adhamato لَقَدْ مَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذْ بَعْثَ فِيهِمْ رَسُولًا. That the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was upon the believers when He sent amongst them a messenger sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam to show us our purpose in life, to show us the reason why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created each and every single one of us. وَلِذَلِكَ خَلَقَهُمْ. And it was for that reason they were created, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. That reason, the worship of the Lord Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'adhamato. And as we've heard, to give victory to the Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Allah Himself Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'adhamato. As we understand the religion of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, clarifies that there are two types of people. In the beginning you saw the manifestation of the full star turn of those two camps, the camp of faith and the camp of disbelief. And likewise the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam informed us that as it was in the beginning, so shall it be in the end, and each and every single generation between the age of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam and the last and final generation of this ummah, they tend likewise towards how it was in the beginning, these two camps. As he said sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, fustatan yawma idhin. He said upon that day at the end of time there will be two camps. He says sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, iman la nifaqa fi, the riwayah, iman la kufra fi, faith in which is not tainted by hypocrisy, and faith which is not tainted by disbelief. The camp, and that's the camp of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, the 313 who were present and the 70 odd who were not present with the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, who were still counted amongst the people of Badr. But likewise also the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, he also spoke about al-kufr, the camp of disbelief, la imana fi, that is not quote unquote tainted by faith, not tainted by belief. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And ultimately inside of life, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates life Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'adhamato as a means of disclosing Himself unto each and every single one of us, whether He discloses Himself through mercy subhanahu wa ta'ala or He discloses Himself through wrath Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'adhamato, as a means of knowing which camp that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ultimately place you in, because you were placed in either of those camps inside of the beginning. And likewise, life will likewise manifest whether you're inside of which camp inside of the end. Hakadar Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the beginning of the narrative of man, ha'ula'i lil jannah wa la ubali, these are created for paradise and it affects me not. Hakadar the words of God Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'adhamato in the beginning of the narrative of man, هَؤُلَا لِلْسَعِيرِ, and these are for the blazing inferno, وَلَا أُبَالِي, and it affects me not. هكذا the words of Allah Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'adhamato, and life will disclose which camp that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed you in. The great Imam Abdullah al-Haddad rahimahullah ta'ala, he speaks about purpose inside of life, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates creation. إِنَّ الْإِلَهِ بَرَاهَا لِيُمَيُّزْ بِهَا بَيْنَ الْأَحْلِ الْحَمْقِ وَالْفِطَنِ, that verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates creation in order to distinguish between the people of intelligence and the people of absolute stupidity. Hakadar, he says, the intelligent are those who realize their purpose in life, and your purpose is to worship Him Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'adhamato. The stupid are those who ignore their purpose and they seek a purpose that stems from the depths of their egotistical and damned nature. How can they seek inside of life? And is that quote unquote not the message of Badr? There are those who stand against Rasulullah, the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, for selfish motives, for dunyawi worldly motives, for motives of the mundane. That is the reason that you find Abu Jahl, Amr ibn Hisham. That is the reason why you find Yani Utbah. That is the reason you find Al-Bakhtari. That is the reason you find all of those people who are damned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who stand against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger for reasons of dunya. وَذُو الْحَمَاقَةِ ظَلَّ يَجْمَعُهَا يَعْنِي يُعَانِي سَعْيَ الْبَيْنَ الشَّامِ وَالْيَمَنِي هَكَذَا الْوَيْسَ الْحَدَّادِ رَحِيبَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى. The people of stupidity, ظَلَّ يَجْمَعُهَا, their whole purpose inside of life is to gather the world in and of itself, هَكَذَا, and to stand in protection of the world in and of itself, as if that will that you seek, that will that you gather, will follow you onto the next world. And hakada many a Muslim, nasar Allah salam al-afiyah, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala often inside of his book, Jalla Jalalo, wa ta'ala ta'adamatum, why does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we hear about the believers, yu'minuna bil-ghayb, yani bil-ghayb, that they believe inside of the unseen. They believe that after death, yani khalaf, there comes another life. And a life that is even greater than the life that they find themselves in. Why is that a common theme inside of the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, when he migrated unto what? Unto Madinatul Munawwara, sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, he found the people of religion. He found the people of the book. He found the yani Banu Israel, the Jews, sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, and from the beliefs of the element of Banu Israel, that although they were believers in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and although they were believers in prophecy in and of itself, they were not believers in life after death. They believed that the whole thing ended at the point of death. And that's why Allah subhanahu in the beginning of Surah Al-Baqarah, Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala azamatu, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the people of true belief, yu'minuna bil-ghayb. That's the first characteristic Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about. Those who believe inside of a next world, do you understand ultimately their purpose inside of life? That their purpose inside of life is not what relates to that which is fan. Kullu ma alayha fan. Everything inside of this world is in a state of annihilation. It's temporal. It's ephemeral. It's not lasting. But those who believe in the Rasul and stand with the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, their purpose is Allah wa rasuluhu wal yawm al akhir. Allah and His Messenger inside in the next world. Hakada radiallahu anhum wardahum. And that you see the two fariqaini, the jama'an, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, yawm al-iltaqa al-jama'an. The day when those two great, mighty, quote-unquote, armies met. An army of the outward, and they had all of, quote-unquote, those outward signs of power. They had the signs of power of people who are recognized upon the face of the world. They had the signs of power in terms of wealth. They had the signs of power in terms of military might. They had signs of power in terms of the steed, quote, or those instruments of war that ultimately, quote unquote, inside of an age where people forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala determined the outcome of battle. But you had another group. That's the Jaman, the group of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, who stood alongside the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, and because of them, quote unquote, we have a chance to be because of them, as we had. In tuhlak hadhi al-usba lan tu'bad fil ard. If this small group of people, 313, are defeated today, lan tu'bad fil ard. You will not be worshipped on the face of the earth ever. Hakada the words of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, as he calls upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by virtue of that name. Asim ibn Balkhiya called upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Hayyu Ya Qayyum. Upon the supreme name of Allah Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala ta'adamato, upon that blessed day sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. As we heard, what did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show? Yani kan min fiyatin qalila. How often do we see a small group? لَقَدْ نَصَرَكُمُ اللَّهُ بِبَدْرٍ وَأَنْتُمَ ذِلَّةٍ. هكذا الله تعالى said, Allah ta'ala gave you victory at Badr وَأَنْتُمَ ذِلَّةٍ. And you were what? You were people who people paid no significance to. And who was the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam? 313 people stood alongside the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You were not one of them. 313 people in the age, where because we've got 1.7 billion Muslims. They were 313. Nobody paid attention to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam. How many tears would have been shed had the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lost his life in battle upon that day? How many tears were shed for those martyrs, Sayyidina Mu'awwidh, Sayyidina Mu'adh radiallahu anhu wa rdamit, Abna al-Afra, those people who died upon that blood? How many tears were shed for such people? Allah Ta'ala bi kalami antum adhilla. Allah Ta'ala bi kalami, that they were qaleel, fiyatul qaleela, that they were the few people radiallahu ta'ala anhum wardahum. But a nasr, ma'alad, as we heard, victories with Allah Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala azabatu, as victories with those people who prefer Him Jalla Jalala wa ta'ala azabatu over everything else. Hakada. Understand Badr yani. Badr, Allah Ta'ala wal aqiba lil muttaqina, that the end of this affair is for the people of taqwa, fattaqullah. لعلكم تشكرون. So have taqwa of Allah Ta'ala, gather the kalam of Allah Ta'ala upon this blessed day. Have taqwa of Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, لعلكم تشكرون. So you may become people who are truly grateful, thankful to the Lord Jalla Jalala wa Ta'ala Ta'azabato. Hakada the theme. The theme is of people who prefer Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. The theme is of the people who prefer the next world. The people who understand that, mashallah, tabarakallah, you live how long? You live 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, 50, 60, 70, then you die. Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut. And what have you contributed inside of life? What is the good, quote unquote, not the carbon footprint, but the good footprint that you've left upon the face of planet Earth? How have you benefited people? How have you gave victory to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How have you brought the mandate of the heavens down to earth in and of itself in an age where the world is in dire need of that mandate that the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahihi wa sallama wa li thalika khalaqahum. That is the only reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us. Allah ta'ala never created you for wealth, manly, manly. My wealth. He never created you for that. Jalla jalala wa ta'ala ta'adabato. Al-mal, mal Allah. Allah ta'ala never created you for you to become of those who seek the dunya in and of itself. Our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wasn't bothered about wealth. Our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never sought wealth. Allah never created you to store it. That the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahibu wa sallam, he never stored the wealth. وَلَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةُ الْحَسَنَةِ. And in the messenger of God, you have a great example, the best example, the most perfect example, the perfect paragon. صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Expose yourself. Because تعرض لنفحات الله. Exposing ourselves to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala disclosure upon special days like this is about doing what these days dictate. What do these days dictate? That day, the 17th of Ramadan, mashallah, tabarakah, in the second year of the Hijrah, radiallahu anhu waradan, they sacrificed their life. That's what it meant, Yahari. Inside maybe the heart of many a believer who was alongside the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sahihi wa sallam, where they're going to live to see their parents, where they're going to live to see their wives, where they're going to live to see their children. Maybe many, the minds of a believer, remember the Sahaba themselves, 3 years later would say, if it was not that he was the messenger of God, nobody would believe him. That's the age they lived in. Nobody would believe in him, yani. What does it mean, yani, to go out alongside the Rasul, sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sahihi wa sallam? They sacrificed their life, they sacrificed their families, they sacrificed their houses, they sacrificed their wealth, they sacrificed, quote unquote, in the age that they lived in, they sacrificed, quote unquote, their honor inside the eyes of man. What is it that each and every single one of us are ready to sacrifice? Tawfiq, hakada nasal.
JazakAllah khair to both Sheikh Harun and Sheikh Ibrahim. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he preserves them inshallah for us, inshallah. We continue inshallah to benefit and become inshallah some of the words that they're saying to us inshallah ta'ala. Okay, inshallah, we're just going to quickly move on inshallah to a set of presentations regarding Seven Worlds Trust. It's pertinent that Sheikh Ibrahim mentioned about the good that we do in the world and the good footprints that we leave in the world inshallah ta'ala for those who come. So it's going to be a bit of an update of the Seven Worlds Trust, which was it was established officially last year. Brother Mubarak from the Seven Worlds team is here. He's going to come and speak, inshallah. And there's going to be, he's going to speak straight after a presentation, inshallah. There's going to be one promo video, is there? It's a promo video, inshallah. There's going to be one promo video. And the Brother Mubarak is going to come and speak and give an update on the Seven Worlds Trust, what it's been doing in the past year.